Andre is anxious to release new music, but that doesn't mean he's actually actively been trying to make that new music. He has been spending his time tinkering and trying to find the right sound, but he's been hitting a wall. This bout of writer's block has been so severe that he's thought about throwing in the towel altogether. During a 2019 appearance on the Broken Record podcast, he told producer Rick Rubin that he's questioning whether he's even supposed to make music at all. As he put it, "I haven't been making much music, man. My focus is not there. My confidence is not there. I tinker a lot. I'll just go to a piano and sit my iPhone down and just record what I'm doing. But I haven't been motivated to do a serious project. I'd like to, but it's just not coming." He added, "In my own self, I'm trying to figure out where do I sit. I don't even know what I am, and maybe I'm nothing. Maybe I'm not supposed to be anything. Maybe my history is kind of handicapping in a way." This isn't to say, though, that Andre has totally disappeared from the music industry. In 2019, for example, he threw down a verse on Anderson .Paak's single Come Home, and he also appeared on the James Blake track Where's the Catch? Andre's biggest hurdle lately seems to be his confidence. He's widely regarded as one of the most innovative rappers of all time, but he doesn't actually think he's all that talented. Instead, he's been spending his time searching to discover his true talents. If anything, his story is proof that you can earn plenty of accolades and still suffer from imposter syndrome. In a 2017 interview with GQ, Andre claimed that he was a jack of no trades who never totally dedicated himself to a single craft. He learned piano just enough to make Miss Jackson, and the first chords he learned on guitar were turned into Hey Ya. One could argue that his talents have more than adequately served their purpose, but he doesn't seem to share that sentiment. He's spending a good chunk of his time filling up hard drive after hard drive of music, just trying to find something he's good at. As he told GQ, "I was trying to find out, what can I be excited about? Because I never was, to me, a great producer, or a great writer, or a great rapper. I always felt that I was less than everybody else, so I fought harder."
You're only good as the music you grew up to and your contemporaries. That's basically what you are.
We would like to take a moment to remind Andre that he made an album that literally won the Grammy for Album of the Year. Andre isn't just an innovator when it comes to music, as he's always had a sense of style to match. So naturally enough, he jumped into the world of fashion in 2008 with the launch of his menswear line, Benjamin Bixby. Today, Andre's style is much more toned down than it was in the early 2000s. He's ditched his chaps and football shoulder pads for basics like long sleeve tees, jeans, and Adidas shoes. He's also still in the business of fashion. In his 2017 GQ interview, he revealed that he planned to design t-shirts for legendary R&B singer Anita Baker. He was inspired to do so after accidentally buying some really awful-looking bootlegs. Following the interview, Baker seemed into the idea as she tweeted, "We'll talk." Along with Peaches and Ray Charles, Outkast is one of Georgia's most beloved exports. The hip-hop duo is so widely adored that in 2019, Andre 3000 and Big Boi were commemorated with a gigantic mural in the heart of Atlanta's Little Five Points neighborhood. Andre doesn't even live there anymore, but that's not to say he doesn't have pride for the place where he built his career. His music has been a tribute to the city and the southern lifestyle, but he's since had to physically move on. In 2017, he revealed that he needed a new start when his parents died and his son went off to college. As he told GQ, "I was like, I've kinda outlived Atlanta. It's not like I go to the studio, I'm just sitting around wasting time and doing stuff I'm not supposed to be doing." Andre hoped that moving to New York City would help him with his career, whether that meant cultivating a new skill or renewing his deflating passion. Ever since, he's been slowly checking off the boxes. He told GQ, "I saw myself coming to study an instrument, coming to learn Spanish, and probably try stage. I've only done one." In 2013, Andre's mother was found dead in her home. A little less than a year later, his father passed away from a heart attack. The rapper is understandably still struggling to deal with his grief. The struggle was especially tough while he was starring in the 2013 movie Jimmy, All Is By My Side. In 2017, he told GQ, "I was in a creative hole, a personal hole, and I was still not dealing with my mom's and my father's deaths. And really, I don't know if I have still. You know, just push that away." The problem with being successful is you can do whatever you do times 10, and no one to stop you. You can easily go down the wrong path, and you get into that place, and the thing that brings you out is other people. Andre ended up experiencing two waves of grief for his dad. First, it was the loss, and then it was realizing that his father had died alone in his home. He told GQ, "I do miss not being able to talk to him about him living alone and not ever being married. I think I would have gotten a lot of great insight. I think he would have told me something." Andre has been in the game for quite a while now. He met Big Boi in high school, and the two of them wanted to sign a record deal when they were 17. But it was a no-go for Andre's parents, so they had to wait until they were legal adults. Big Boi ended up graduating with honors, while Andre dropped out in the 11th grade. Their rap career was a quick success, which led to Andre missing out on some important life lessons. When he was 17, he wrote his first check because his mum was teaching him how to use a checkbook, but he never had to write one ever again because Outkast exploded. This massive success was great for avoiding certain practical tasks, but when Andre retreated from the spotlight, he had a lot of catching up to do. As he put it to GQ, "There's so many social norms I just don't know. Since age 17, people have catered to me and Big Boi. It's strange when, your whole life, everyone has treated you different from everybody else. They say that if you're an entertainer, whatever time you took off, you stay that age. I was 17.
First, you have to be hip. And the older you get further away from the hipness."
Andre is best known for his rapping with Outkast, but he's also a Grammy-winning producer. Back at the height of his fame, he actually produced a number of Outkast's albums, including The Love Below, as well as Khaleesi's 2003 album, Tasty. In 2017, he told GQ that he's been focusing his efforts on producing in recent years, though he's struggled a bit because of his age. As he revealed, "I hate going to the studio, so what's got me going once again is me being excited about other artists. I've been working on producing a few artists, a couple projects. But here's the crazy thing, I don't have the pulse anymore." He added, "Rhythms change every generation. The intensity and the drums change, and I'm not on the pulse. I can't pretend. It's kind of like watching your uncle dance. So the only thing I can do is this kind of novelty off thing for them." In 2014, Andre was tapped to produce Aretha Franklin's take on Nothing Compares to You for her covers album. This was his first production project since Outkast. He told NPR at the time, "It's not like I'm a hot producer or anything right now, so when I got the call, I was honestly surprised."
"Always about the actual song or the project, you know, I never just say I'm going to do something just to do it."
Andre 3000 was once voted Peter's World's Sexiest Vegetarian, but those days are long behind him. His attractiveness certainly hasn't faded, though his devotion to a plant-based diet has. He originally adopted the lifestyle after a stretch of hard partying on the road. In 2017, he told GQ, "I was doing drugs, partaking in every woman, and I started to see myself deteriorate. I would look in the mirror and be like, you look like so I got to a point where I said, I gotta stop. So I went that way and tried veganism. But it seems that he eventually grew a little resentful and a little hangry. In 2014, he told Esquire, "I was a hardcore vegan for 15 years. I've even done raw. But socially, it became horrible. I was kind of just sitting at home eating a salad. You become mean. That's not good for you." Part of Andre 3000's retreat from the spotlight might have something to do with his social anxiety. In his 2017 interview with GQ, he opened up about his mental health. He revealed, "I was diagnosed with this social thing. I didn't notice it until I became an entertainer. I don't know if it's the shock of all kinds of people coming up to you or the expectations, but I got to this place where it was hard for me to be in public without feeling watched or really nervous." Andre moved to California soon after this issue arose. He thought he was possibly just in need of a break, but the problem got worse and worse until it started to bleed into his personal life. As he put it, I'd just meet new people and I would freak out or have to leave. He added, the more you run from it, the worse it gets. You don't want to explain it because you don't want to be a weak link around your friends. I never told my crew for a long time, so I just started getting to myself, spending more time with myself and stopped touring. And it felt great for me to do that because it's like, phew, I don't like that life. I don't like that confrontation. Ultimately, Andre hoped that moving to New York would help him confront his anxiety, as a city that's so densely populated and relies so heavily on public transportation doesn't allow much space to hide. Here's hoping that he finds the peace he's looking for.
Just never know, one little thing leads to another.
Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more Nicki Swift videos about your favorite stars are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.